Okay, is anybody here? It says we're live, but
are you there?
Yeah, but you digitized. It might be a problem on my end because you digitized the whole time when you were talking to me previously. And I was having a problem with Facebook earlier, like 5 minutes earlier, where it's saying not connecting, which is totally random. I don't know why I would choose, but.
Okay. Well, we're not going to have a very long talk anyway tonight. So. Mm-hmm. You know, if we do get cut off, everybody will understand, right?
Yeah, no, definitely. But I'm here now, so what were you saying before my internet froze up?
Well, I was going to ask you if you had a favorite topic you wanted to talk about for about 30 minutes.
Well, I could talk a little bit more just about genealogy, like, because I work on it all the time, and I keep thinking about it. I can talk a little bit more about that, which to me, it's an evergreen topic. It's continuing to be something people are interested in. I can share about that. Was there anything that you wanted to share about?
Well, not really. I mean, I know there were a bunch of pipe bombs that were sent to people, very strange stuff, but I haven't been keeping up with that.
I haven't either. And I wouldn't know all the details. I just know that something bad happened and I didn't really keep up. So I read some of the news, but not the last 2 days. But what I'll do is I'm just going to share about genealogy because that's what I've been working on. Like, I have many interests, but lately, again, genealogy. Are we live, by the way, right now?
Yes, we are. I had to go live because it was time.
Oh, yeah.
I have people telling me that they are there and they don't see me. So I don't know what that means.
Well, it just, what I want to do is let me share the link though. So I do want to make sure, even though this, like, let me just go to the YouTube and I'm going to share our link, not to prolong how long we're doing things tonight. I just want to make sure, you know, people who see us can see us. Let's see.
Okay.
So let me just do that real fast and then go back to Facebook. And
I do hear a little bit of an echo of your voice. Are you sure that you muted what you're looking at?
Yeah, actually it is muted. The only place where it's up, like where the sound is on our Hangout. Just strange. Like, I don't know why it's doing that unless it's just my webcam. It never did that before. Okay, let me just see. Okay, and I are I'm not trying to pause, but okay. So I shared it on our wall. So what I'll share about is I'm just gonna share a little bit more about like genealogy and working on it. A lot of people, they continue to have very mixed feelings about the DNA test, but the interesting thing about it is they're saying now they can link like almost half the US population, because even if you're choosing not to take a DNA test, you probably had a relative who did. So if you're abstaining from it, it's not that they can't find you. Like some people, that's one controversy, but what I focus on, it's not the controversies. I don't really care about that as much. What I liked about the DNA test was yesterday I was just looking, like I'd been corresponding with this distant cousin and I looked on Ancestry and I noticed she had taken the DNA test and now we can see that we are definitely 100% distantly related, which I thought was like, I just thought that was neat that we already knew, like I already had a feeling before I had asked her. I thought you know, I think we must be distantly related because we have ancestors who came from the same village. And it just seems like, you know, I just have a feeling, and she confirmed it through records. But then I saw the test and I'm like, oh, we're distantly related. That's, it just was exciting to see that the test, the science, could show what we already knew through the documentation, which I just really liked. And then another thing that I liked about that was that I have another distant cousin who I thought, well, like, I thought I'd probably be more distantly related to her than this person, but it turns out I'm more distantly, slightly more distantly related to that person than the other person. So, like, I kind of have a theory, like, I'm like, I wonder how now, like, I'm related to this person. It's just kind of fun. It's like a puzzle. Like, some people are like, whatever. There's two different types of people that like genealogy. Some people just take the test for fun to see what their results are. Some people want to work on their family tree. I like everything. I like to look at the census. I like to look at immigration documents. I like to look at church records. I like a little bit of everything. Newspaper clippings. I find it really fascinating to just go back in time, like, find out why, like, why did people immigrate? What was their life like? Like, to me, this is just an interesting topic. Like, I just become immersed in it, and I can get lost in it for hours. So, I don't know, like, I highly recommend it, but it is still, right now, a lot of people are like, some people don't want to take the DNA test, some people do, some people just want to do the research, so... That's what I've been working on. Have you been working on any projects or anything?
Well, I wanted to share with you this necklace that I got from my daughter. I don't usually wear jewelry, but she sent it to me through the mail, so I really like it.
Oh, that's really pretty. And what was, like, what is the, like, pendant part of it again? Like, I couldn't really tell.
Well, I think it's a false pearl. It's not really a pearl, but the idea is it looks like one.
I love that kind of jewelry, actually. Like, I just think some people think it has to be really fancy, expensive jewels. But I love costume jewelry, in my opinion. And the cool thing about costume jewelry is sometimes it's more durable, and it's actually... it might get passed down because there's more of it. I don't know. I love that kind of jewelry. I used to make a lot of jewelry, actually, and I started wearing jewelry again a little bit more recently. I'm like, I forgot, oh, I made that, and I made that. It's nice. It's a nice necklace.
Yeah, thank you. Well, you know, I'm at a place where instead of sending my daughter cards and, you know, she sent me a Halloween card with some candy and this, and I'm so happy about it.
Your daughter is really, she's a very thoughtful person. I always think she has really good taste too. Like, I see a lot of the little things that she gets you. Like, she's thoughtful and she has good taste. So that's very charming and sweet.
Yeah.
So do you have plans for Halloween? Do you and Beau give out candy, or do you guys not really?
No, that never happens around here. I mean, the first Halloween that we were ever here, and this was before Beau was born, we were waiting for him to be born, but I got this big orange bowl, and I filled it with all kinds of candy, and Sword was 2 years old, and she'd never experienced Halloween because we had been living in Taiwan before that. Mm-hmm. So I wanted her to experience it, and I wanted her to know what we were going to expect, you know, what would happen. So I said, we're going to fill this with candy. You're going to wear a costume. She dressed up as Poe from Teletubbies. I don't know if you're familiar with Teletubbies.
But Teletubbies, yeah, there were lots of before like Facebook, just like messages that people would send through the old email about them, like jokes about Teletubbies. I used to get these random jokes. I'd be like, I don't know what that means, and then I had to ask my sister, who had a child around your age, like, what is a Teletubby? And she's like, this is what a Teletubby is,
right? You know, my friend here is telling me, let me know when you are going live, but I have that we are live. Is that
live? Yeah, because I looked and I'm going to refresh it. Like, it's definitely silent, so it can't be making.
Could you message Michelle for me, because I don't message that well that fast.
Okay, let me do that. Let me do that to let Michelle know that we're on. Let's see.
Give her the link, because maybe the link is somehow not what she was expecting, because I had a feeling that we were thrown out of something.
But she also, join us? Like, is she going to come in on as a guest joining us, like as a voice? Or
No. Just she cannot see us.
Okay, I get you. I didn't know, like, if she wanted to be like a guest tonight or something. I guess I was just trying to figure out like what she, I'm not sending it to you. Like, Julia.
Just if you could send her the link that everybody else.
Oh yeah, I'm sending her the main link. I started resending it somewhere else. There we go. So I sent it to Michelle and I let Michelle know you're live. I think the problem is I finally am getting a little bit better with the Google notifications, but I noticed like if I'm logged into Google, it doesn't always show me, but if I'm like on my YouTube account, but on a separate YouTube account that's not mine, it will notify me that your channel has gone live, because I had my secondary channel subscribed to you just to see if I'd get the notification. And it seems like that's how I know, which is kind of totally random.
Anyway. Okay, so I was going to tell you how it was here with Sword. And when we first came here, I had this orange bowl full of candy, you know, the very best candy possible. You know, we went all out and we waited and waited for somebody to come trick-or-treating. And nobody ever showed up the whole night. And Sword was so disappointed. She said, didn't they want our candy? But it just wasn't done anymore. I mean, when I was young, it was done. I went trick-or-treating in neighborhoods where I didn't know anybody and nobody thought that anything bad would happen to me. Mm-hmm. But we are here out in the country and the houses are, you know, half a mile apart.
It's hard.
Well, it's not really too far if people actually walked, but they don't walk anymore. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, no, I wouldn't. But a half a mile is really not that far to walk. Like, okay, people still trick or treat, like in a lot of our little towns here. I know they say people don't anymore, but this is the difference. We kind of have a small townish vibe to our city. So there are like residential communities where people trick or treat still here. But I know some people don't either. Like, I know sometimes now they just have, like, people. But that's too bad. So you didn't get a lot of trick-or-treaters then?
We didn't get any trick-or-treaters. But, you know, Bo's experiences with Halloween were that he did dress up one time. You know, when he was about 3 years old, he was dressed as a pumpkin. And later on, and that was before he was really talking to me, later on, when he was in the pens and he actually started to spell out things, and I asked him, do you remember when you dressed up for Halloween? He said, yes. And I asked him, well, do you remember what you were? And he said, pumpkin. So, yeah. Which he was black.
He knew he was a pumpkin.
Yeah. But we don't really do that. Here's the thing. Bo doesn't like to wear clothes. A costume is usually clothes, right?
Mm-hmm. That's true. It's clothing.
Right. So, I mean, it's not like, I mean, one time he said to me, why don't you ever give me clothes? Like, I'm the person who didn't want him to wear clothes. Oh, my goodness. I worked so hard to keep him in clothes until at age 5. I just had to give up. I had to understand that wasn't his thing, and I had to accept it. You know, it's not all about what I want. He's a chimpanzee. He's not a human being. He's not made for wearing clothes. And so I had to let it go. And when I let it go, that's when the potty training started to work. Okay. So it was a good thing that I let it go.
Yeah.
But one time he said to me, "Why don't you ever let me wear clothes?" But, you know, he was pulling my leg because it was clearly I had tried to keep clothes on him for such a long time. So I gave him this. It was around Christmas time. So I gave him the Santa Claus outfit to wear. He had a lot of fun putting on the pants and then taking off the pants and putting on the pants and taking off the pants. But it wasn't like he really wanted to wear anything. He just wanted to play with it for a while.
It's just like, it was like a game, it sounds like.
Yeah. Him. Yeah. That's what it was. So people are asking, what is Bo going to do for Halloween? Well, I'll give him a minute quantity of candy because I don't really think it's that good for him or for any of us.
Really. Yeah, we probably shouldn't be eating candy. I'm a hypocrite. I'm eating some trail mix right now, but whatever. I haven't ate much all day. But
no, my daughter also sent me candy. I'm not going to eat it. I appreciate the thought. It's a very sweet thought, but I'm not going to do that because it's so not good for me.
It's probably not good for any of us. I just, like, I don't know. Like, if I haven't made all day, I kind of, but there's nuts in here too, so I don't feel so bad about eating the peanut.
Yeah, that makes sense. Yeah, so that's Halloween. So I'm not going to see Sword for Halloween. That's why she sent me the card. But I will see her for Thanksgiving.
She's, like, busy with school, but that's kind of exciting because they're getting farther into their degree and they're working on projects. I kind of miss that, like, the college experience. I didn't like high school, but I just loved being at university and studying and working on a degree, like... Some people are like so excited to graduate because they just want to be working. But I don't know. I just love being a college student. And I probably would have done that indefinitely if it didn't cost copious amounts of money. That probably sounds horrible, but I just love being a student in college, not in high school.
Yeah. I loved grad school. I wasn't so happy in law school, mm-hmm. but I loved being in grad school.
You had a really good group of people, though, didn't you, that you worked with on your dissertation?
Yes, I did. It was a really nice experience, and I kind of regret that I didn't have it earlier in my life because it would just have opened more doors.
Definitely. And don't people still cite some of your work or your dissertation that you wrote when you were working on that program?
That my dissertation gets cited a lot. I'm on Google Scholar, so you can see who cites me.
Yeah, I just think that's a good thing to share because I know you've written books, and it's nice for people to know that, you know, that your dissertation is still being used, I think, you know.
Yeah, yeah. Well, a lot of my articles are still cited, and... you know, year after year after year, and I get Google Scholar notifications that happens.
Yeah, we got this real weird in comment. I guess it's because I'm eating trail mix, but my goodness. Okay, but anyway, so
did you say there was a comment from somebody on the?
Yeah.
What did they say?
They wanted to. It's bad.
It's okay.
No. Anyways, I was gonna ask, like, so what other projects are coming up when you're working on different things? Because I know you said some things are coming up with like libertarian issues and stuff recently.
Oh well, you know, the election is coming up right now. And I'm going to vote for Jacob Campbell, mm-hmm. Who is the Libertarian candidate for senator. There's a marijuana legalization bill. I don't think it's the best because I think that they're going to treat it like an illness, and then people will maybe lose their right to bear arms if they sign up for that.
Oh, really?
I have mixed feelings about it. Austin Peterson is supporting it, but I'm not sure how I feel about it, you know?
Yeah, no, I know what you're saying. I think what was better, like, I personally have never dabbled in any of that, but I think what's finally better here in California is when they just legalized it. I have no interest in it. I don't want to eat brownies with nothing. But I think that was better because now people don't have to go to the dispensary, and they were always like, oh, the dispensary is 500 feet from school. And they were just like, there were so many issues with it. So I think it was just better when like a small amount of it was just legal, and then that took away the issue. So I don't know, but that's just my take. Not the medical part, but just it's legal for people to buy it like small amount recreationally. But
that makes
sense. No interest. Yeah, I have no interest in it. So I just.
Yeah, neither do I.
But then this is the weird thing that along with that I don't really understand. Like now they're like cracking down more on like underage drinking, which, okay, I don't like underage drinking, but they were like having stings, like trying to like find people if they would buy a drink for somebody that was like, I don't know, 18 or 19. I just think that's kind of a waste of time. Like,
that's not underage drinking. See, the thing is, if the age of consent is 18, the age to serve in the military is 18, the age to vote is 18, then you can't say that that's underage drinking.
Yeah.
It doesn't make any sense.
And I don't even drink. Like, I don't care about any of these things, but it's interesting, like, all these different things. But here's one issue that I thought was interesting. I was looking, like, how libertarians feel and how Democrats feel on the propositions. And I was noticing the libertarians didn't take a stance, but then the Democrats they want to get rid of daylight savings time here in California, but not really get rid of it. What they want to do is they want to sync up our time zone with Arizona, which doesn't observe daylight savings time, which would put us in mountain time year round. But then when everybody goes on daylight savings time and mountain time, we would just be in sync with Arizona. So they said that changing the clock two times a year is causing more accidents, and it's making it harder for people to get up or go to sleep, and it's causing like a large amount of accidents. So I'm still like trying to weigh like the whole daylight savings time. Do you have any feelings about that daylight savings time?
I don't like it. I think we should just stick to a particular time zone that we're in and have, you know, year round, to have nature do what nature does.
Yeah. But this is the weird thing. Like, I guess I'm going to maybe vote for it, but I have mixed feelings because now if I vote for it, that means we're going to change our time zone and be with Arizona like all the time. And then we won't be with Oregon and Washington, which I think
might make sense.
It's going to cause more confusion. And I'm like, I don't know. It makes me not want to vote for it. It makes me think, okay, I don't love daylight savings time, but that's going to cause more confusion than changing the time two times per year.
Yeah. Yeah, I can see that. I can definitely see that.
Some of these propositions are just very, like, I'm going through it. I like some of the libertarian stances on them, but I'm still thinking about them. I'm just like, yeah, I don't know. I'll have to think about them a bit more. It could end up being like the plastic bag. Everybody thinks that they're helping the environment with that plastic bag law, but people still use plastic bags to throw their trash away. So until you find a way to recycle your trash, like, why do we have to be charged for a plastic bag when people still have plastic bags?
I agree with you on that. I went over to Orchard House and I picked up some plastic bags that were left over there so I could use them for my trash, because I was running out of plastic bags.
Yeah, and I found out, like, there's some stores you can go to, they don't care if you ask for plastic bags, and it was food for less. I'm like, you know what, I like that. I like shopping at Walmart, but it's always a problem because, like, some days of the week they don't have bags, and if you don't bring a bag with you, then you're out of luck. But if you go to Food for Less, they always have bags, and they don't even care how many bags you buy. Like, one guy just came in one day and he said, I want to buy 50 bags, and the lady was like, okay, I have to ask my manager, but they didn't care. They sold him 50 bags. They didn't ask him why. They just sold it to him and he was on his way. And I like that. So
it wasn't a big deal,
you know?
Right.
But anyway, I'm just trying to figure out all the propositions. Do you guys have like 12 propositions on your ballot?
I don't think so, but you know, I haven't looked at up into her ballot yet, so I don't know.
My ballot is just like, it's so big. You take it out and it just goes, this is the first page. And you flip it, it just goes on and on. We have a really large ballot. So
yeah,
more about it.
Right.
But so was there anything else that you wanted to talk about right now, like this going on this week?
No, I didn't really have any particular topic. I just wanted to make sure that we stayed on schedule.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the thing with Larry Dabelmont did not work out, you know, because he doesn't have the technology. But a lot of the people in the creative writing group are getting together with Larry Dabelmont to put together a magazine about outdoor life. And so I'm very interested in that.
Yeah, I think a lot of people, they just aren't well-versed with the technology to do Google Hangouts. And I started to realize, like, what we do, it's kind of, like, it's kind of intensive, like, because I know a lot of people do live streams, but a lot of people don't. Like, a lot of people are very, they just don't understand how all these different social media platforms work and how to sync the technology. It's not easy, so I think the fact that we've gotten to this point is really good.
Yeah.
You know, I'm excited about it, you know, learning more about it, perfecting it to make it work even better.
Yeah, I think that our live streams have a chance to really make an impact in the future. And we've learned how to share images online. We've learned how to look at the chat while we're still doing it. So we're doing pretty well.
Yeah, I think so. And I guess I'm going to check again. And so, yeah, I'm so glad, like, somebody made a comment about comment. But they didn't have to. Some people are just like, ha, ha, ha. But it's all good. I'm not even going to acknowledge that. So what else was I going to say? I've been reading. I know I shared a little bit about this book earlier, the Alice Network, but I had just started reading it, but I've continued to read it a little bit more. And it's just really fascinating, just about the female spies during World War I and all the, like, how nobody would suspect they were carrying messages, and they would roll up like coded messages in their hair. And this one lady, she took on all these different personas. Like, she could be, I don't know, a laundress, she could be a cheesemaker, and these were real people that were actually spying for the British and the French, you know, against the Germans in occupied France. So I just thought it was kind of fascinating to realize, yes, there have been women spies. Like, it's not a new thing. But we always knew that, because remember, they wrote in coded ink and other things too in the past. So it's just kind of it's an interesting book. It's historical fiction. It is, you know, contrived, but I like, another thing I thought was interesting when I was reading the book that I had never heard of before was during the First World War, I guess, like, the Germans would just go in and take whatever they wanted from French residences, and then they'd give you a bond, which was a voucher for anything they took, but it wasn't worth anything. I just thought that was kind of amusing, like...
Okay, well, I'm going to start thing, and we'll sign off. So I thought it was interesting, the Nicholas Sarwark, who is the head of the National Libertarian Party, he's running for mayor of Phoenix. And do you know what he calls people who are residents of Phoenix?
Phoenicians.
Phoenicians, yeah.
Yeah, because Phoenix is rising out of the Phoenix. They're Phoenicians. It's based on East Mediterranean, history.
Yeah, I think that's really interesting. I've never thought of people living in Phoenix as Phoenicians. I hope they really do become Phoenicians. But, on that note, I think we might want to end it tonight.
Okay, sounds good to me. So, well, it was interesting hearing about that, and maybe we can hear an update about his election.
Okay, very good. So good night, Julia.
Okay, have a good night.